We have two main methods of fertilizer application,
okay,
which is basal application and top dressing application.
Okay.
If I have a land and it's fertile and I want to apply NPK, I can use about...
In our last video, we talked about plant nutrients in general, and in today's video, we promise you we are going to talk about the fertilizer application, the tips and tricks, the right time, quantity and method of application. So make sure you watch this video to the end. We have a lot of questions we need to answer from Roman, Kojo, Ikena and a whole lot of people that we need to answer. Mr. Bwachi, so we've talked about plant nutrients for some time now. So today we want to look at the right way of applying fertilizer.
Okay, when you talk of fertilizer application,
okay,
we have two main methods. But before we come to the methods of applying fertilizers,
okay,
research has shown that about 20 to 35% of plant nutrients, which is fertilizer, is lost by smallhold farmers through wrongful and wrong-term application.
Okay.
So fertilizer application is very important, because when you talk of 20 to 30% is something, meaning that if you have 10 bars of NPK at the cost of 400 cedis, which is 4,000, 20% of 4,000 or 30% of 4,000 is a big money.
Okay.
So when they say that 20 to 35% of fertilizer or the nutrient that you apply to maize is lost because of wrongful application, then we must take time and explain or educate the way we should go with our fertilizer application. If not, at the end of the day, our cost is going to exceed our revenue.
Okay.
So when you talk of methods of fertilizer application, we have two main methods of fertilizer application,
okay,
which is basal application and top dressing application.
Okay. Which one is the basal application?
The basal application for that method is good for the organic manure. For that one, you spread the manure or the fert like potash,
okay,
on the land before you plow the land.
Okay.
That is the basal application.
Okay.
When you look through this video, you can see that the farmer is spreading the manure or the fertilizer,
okay,
using a simple machine. There's a battery in the machine,
okay,
which allows the machine to spread the fertilizer instead of using your hand to broadcast the fertilizer.
Okay.
You have a simple machine that we use to do that way. This is the basal application.
Okay.
After,
so what's the name of this machine?
This machine that we use to broadcast this seed or fertilizer.
Okay. What's
that's what we use. In fact, it don't have a specific name,
okay,
but we use for basal application and manual application.
Oh, okay. So when you go to any agri shop,
if you come to my shop, you can get.
Okay. Do you have some in your shop?
Yeah, I have some in my shop. You can use that one. So when it's finished like that, the tractor too will plow the land.
Okay, so this one looks like a bit of manual work.
Yes, manual work.
Do you have any other machine that can do the spreading without getting yourself involved like this?
Oh, for that one is not there. For the broadcast method, most of the broadcast method, you have to, it's more or less manual.
Okay.
Because if not because of this machine, the farmer would have used hand. When he picked the manual, then he spread it like this.
Oh, okay.
Broadcast it like this.
Okay.
Broadcast it like that. But because of that simple machine, that is why you put the fertilizer or the manual inside that battery machine.
So we've talked about the organic fertilizer already. So if you haven't watched it, I'll be leaving a link in the description section so that after watching this video, you go and watch that one too, to give you more insight on the purpose of the organic fertilizer.
So this is the basal application.
Okay.
It's normally spread on the land before you plant.
Okay.
That's a basal application.
Okay.
And the next type of application is called top dressing.
Top dressing.
Yes.
So the basal application is done before plowing.
Yes.
Okay.
And for the top dressing method, that is where the problem lies. After the 2 weeks of following germination, as you have said, you have to give the maize plant nutrient, which is NPK.
Okay.
Either 23-10-5, 20-10-10 or 15-15. As we have already discussed.
Okay.
But for this method, the farmer will apply the fertilizer on every plant.
Okay.
That is top dressing.
Mm.
As you can see in this video, the farmers are applying the fertilizers.
Okay.
On every plant. Have you seen some fertilizer?
How are they doing it? Are they putting it by the side of the...
Yes, they are putting it by the side of the maize.
Okay. So I think we have a question like that.
Yeah.
From Ikena.
Yeah.
Okay, he said, please, I want to know the actual measurement or quantity of fertilizer that should be applied to each maize plant and the distance of the fertilizers from the maize, both for the NPK and the urea. I think this is what you're
talking about. This is what I'm talking about.
Okay.
But for the distance, it's 5 centimeters from the plant.
Okay.
And it can be, if you use a right method of planting, it can be in between the plants.
Okay.
Yes. Apart from that, we have a lot of factors that influence the application of fertilizer. For the quantity, if you want to know the quantity, there are a lot of factors.
Okay.
One, the fertility of the land. Two, the time that you are applying fertilizer is one.
Okay.
And three, the location or the weather.
Okay.
Let's talk about the fertility of the land. If I have a land and it's fertile and I want to apply NPK, I can use about 30 grams.
Okay.
If I say 30 grams, you can put a full of your hand, like your arms.
Okay.
Then you use it for 5 plants.
Okay. So something like this?
Like this.
For five?
5 plants.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It can be for 5 plants, 4 plants, or 6 plants, depending on the fertility of your land.
Okay.
So that is the NPKs.
So what if you have a land that is very fertile and you decide to still give your plants more NPK? What will happen?
Nothing will happen, but it's asking for the measurements. So this one is if you want to accurate measurements or the way you want to go
so
about
30
it.
Grams.
Yes, 30 grams. You see, our farmers, when you talk of 30 grams, 40 grams, 50 grams at times,
yes,
it will be very difficult for them. But we have the manual way of measuring, which is also accurate. So as I said, when you pick full arms like this, then you apply to 5
okay.
plants.
Okay.
So when the land is not fertile, like a sandy soil, you can apply to 4 plants. Have you seen how it goes?
Oh, okay.
Depending on the fertility of your land.
Okay.
Two, plant population. How many plants are there in a hole?
Okay.
If you put 3 maize in one hole, don't expect to give 30 grams to 3 plants.
Okay.
Have you seen where the technicalities come in?
Okay, so
if one hole is for 1 maize, then the 30 grams or 1 arm for 5 plants is applicable.
Okay.
But if you put 3 maize or 3 seed or 4 seed or 2 seed in one hole, meaning that 30 grams must be increased, because now you are not feeding 1 plant, but you are feeding 2 plants.
Oh, okay. So let's assume it's 2 each.
Yes.
Per hole. That means that with the 30 grams, you should divide it for the 6 plant, which is going to be 3 holes.
I said
no, you said 30 grams.
Yes.
Can be for 6 plants or 5 plants.
No, 30 grams is for 1 plant. Look at the explanation. Well, no, look at the explanation. When I pick 1 full arm of this is full of NPK.
Okay.
I can apply it to 5, 2, 3, 4, 5 plants, which I assume each of the plants receive 30 grams of what?
Oh, okay.
Of nutrients. Very good. So if the hole is about 2 or 3 plants, don't expect to put 30 grams or 10 grams or 20 grams. That's why I said that it depends on 1, the fertility of the land, 2, the plant population, and 3, the timing of application, and 4, the type of fertilizer that you are applying.
Okay.
There are some fertilizers, when you apply some few times, it will dissolve. But we have another
What are those fertilizers?
When you apply, it will not dissolve early like that. Huh. So the type of fertilizer, the company that you are buying the fertilizer, each company has the way it processes its own fertilizer. That one too is a factor.
Okay.
Yes. So now I've mentioned 2 factors so far as the quantity to apply is concerned. I've mentioned 1, the fertility of the land. 2, I've also mentioned the timing. And 3, I've mentioned the plant population and also the quality of the fertilizer or the NPK that you are applying.
Okay.
That can influence the quantity fed that should be applied to 1 maize. But you see, this fertilizer application, it goes with the saying that what you sowed is what you harvested. At times people say you reap what you sow.
Okay.
So the more the plant get more nutrient, the more ability and vigor that the plant gets to bear big fruits.
Oh, okay. So let's assume I have the fertilizer that can dissolve early.
Yeah.
What should be the quantity to apply?
For that one, we have 1 method. Although you are doing top dressing, but it's better you cover the fert.
Okay.
You put it there, then you cover. You put there, you cover. You see, that's the best application. When we are young, at times when we go to farm to apply fertilizer, they give us some stick like a peg. You put it there on every seed before, and 1 person like I'm doing, another 2 is applying, another 1, 2 is covering.
Okay.
If you don't do that because of the nitrogen content. That's why I said that the farmers lose about 20 to 35% of fertilizer due to leaching and volatilization.
Okay.
Have you seen? So the best way is that if the fertilizer dissolves early, you have to put it there. Anytime you put it there, you have to cover. Okay. Anytime you put even
what should be the distance of the hole?
For the distance about 1.5 to 2 inches. It's not too deep.
Okay.
Either the fertilizer is hard or is soft, the best way is
to cover it.
That one there, you get about 90% of the nutrient.
Okay.
But you, nowadays, the top dressing, we just put it there and leave it. That is why we lose about 20 to 35% of nutrient through this fertilizer application. And also, one thing about fertilizer application is time is very important. We don't apply fertilizer when it is raining or you are expected that it will rain.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
What will happen?
When you apply fertilizer, when it is raining, you know the fertilizer is more of nitrogen and phosphorus. As soon as you put it there, the rain will wash it away.
Okay.
So at the end of the day, the quantity of the nutrient that the plant is supposed to get, the plant will not get. You lose all the fertilizers.
I thought maybe
and also,
the water will help
no.
the fertilizer to dissolve.
No. Not immediate like that.
Oh, okay.
When you apply the fertilizer, it should be about, if you are lucky, 2, 3 days, 4 days, even 1 week, because before it rains, it is good.
Okay.
But as I said already, if you're able to bury the fertilizer, as I said, when it rains, it will not affect it much.
Okay.
But when this top dressing, you just apply the fertilizer under the maize and you leave it and it rains, that is where it's going to affect the plants. You don't get the nutrient that the plant is supposed to get.
So let's assume I apply my fertilizer today and it rains today. But what you are saying, I might lose some of the nutrients. I will not get all the nutrients again.
Yes.
Do I need to reapply again?
What you have to do is that the second application, you have to increase the nitrogen.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And also, when we are going to apply fertilizer, it shouldn't be early in the morning. When you talk of we decide another application, the early in the morning will be good when you reach there. But fertilizer application early in the morning is not good,
so
because we are talking about the dew. I'm talking about the dew. You see, every morning around 4, 5:30 there is a dew.
Yeah.
So when you get to the farm, in some places you see that it seems it has rained, but it has not rained.
Yeah.
When you pick the fertilizer and you put it under the maize, you see maybe the tips of the maize, there will be some small water.
Yes.
So it will melt the fertilizer. That is why it's not advisable to apply fertilizer early in the morning.
So what's the best time?
Around 10 o'clock, 11, if you like, 4 to 5 o'clock is good.
Okay.
Yeah.
To apply the fertilizer.
To apply the fertilizer.
And can I apply, I apply it around 6 p.m. in the evening? Or
yeah, if the farm is not big, you can do.
Okay.
Like you have your garden, you can do. But you have a big farm, you cannot apply fertilizer around 6 p.m. Because by 1 hour time, you are entering 7 o'clock.
Yes,
when we come to second application, which is the ammonia and the urea too.
Okay. So we are going to end this video here. In the next video, we'll continue with the fertilizer application so that you can be able to get all the information you need. Some of your questions have been answered in the second episode. So if you have asked a question and you are not seeing it in this episode, watch out for the second episode and you see the question answered. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.